What would you like to say to everyone here today who's come to celebrate your 90th birthday?
I say praise the Lord, and I am so glad you're each and every one of you that are here. And I love each and every one of you, and you're my friends and my family, and God knows how much I love you, and I know He loves each and every one of you also.
So, if you would give us some words of advice from what you've learned over 90 years of living, what would they be?
I think one thing especially is to live in the Word of God. We read words in books, newspapers, and etc., but read the Word, because the Word of God directs your life. Every day, no matter what you're facing, it's not so hard that with God's help that you can't face it. And I would say, read the Word, be kind to other people, watch your words because God hears them, and honor Him with your words as though He was sitting. And I would say, cherish each day as a priceless gift.
So, could you give us one of your favorite memories from childhood?
One of my favorite memories is to go to the New Hope Methodist Church for the big Christmas tree. And our Sunday school teachers always gave us a little gift. It may have been just homemade candy in a little hanging basket, but it was always the happiest time for we children to get to go to the Christmas tree and hear the program where they lifted up the birth of Christ. And that was a happy memory. And another happy memory as a child was playing in our big yard with a big collie dog riding in the wagon and playing with my older sister that always wanted to get rid of me so she could play with her older friends. But I just love living on the farm, working with my whole family in the big family farm.
Now, could you share a memory from when you were a young adult, a young married, or when you were a mother of young children?
Well, all of that comes back to mind when we were first married. What a happy time we had with other young couples getting together and playing sit back or just going on a picnic or being together as friends. And then a year and almost 2 years after we were married, our first baby came along. And then we associated with other friends that had young babies. And during the war came on, and we moved to Wilmington, North Carolina. And a lot of the wives, the people whose husband was working at the shipyard, like my husband was, we would get together with our little children and swap stories of what they did do and didn't do. And during that time, there was a big hurricane, and my husband and I was trying to close a screen door on a little back porch, and the wind was so strong, he and I pulled with all of our might trying to pull that door too, and we got so tickled because the wind was so strong, it decided it wanted the door open, and we were not strong enough to close it. So these are some of the things that that we did during those years. And then another fun thing that I remember, planning a surprise birthday parties for my husband. And it was so much fun that I would delay going somewhere, just pretend to be doing something else. And he would get so annoyed. Well, we're going to be late. We're going to be late. And I was just in the back room delaying everything and laughing because I didn't want to get there early. And then when we got there, everybody would start singing happy birthday. And that was a fun thing during our young life together, rearing our children. And I praise God for Christian mate that God planned for me to marry him. And I left Georgia and came to Greensboro, North Carolina, because he had my husband waiting for me there and for me to meet him. And that's where it all came about, that we fell in love and got married. Thank you.
Okay, now this is a quiz, and it's going to get a little bit harder as we go. Here's the first question. How many children do you have?
I have three.
Okay, that was an easy one.
Yeah.
Second question. How many grandchildren do you have?
I have seven.
Okay, now you're doing pretty well. Now here's where it gets difficult. How many great-grandchildren do you have?
Either 16 or 17. I may have to wait and count that up.
Okay, we'll give you that one. Now, finally, how many great-great-grandchildren do you have?
Not it.
Okay, the good. Thank you. Just did a recount on the great-grandchildren, and what's the total now?
Oh, there's 19. Now.
19.
I didn't think I had that right.
19. I'd say your family's done pretty well for itself.
Yeah.
In 90 years of living, you've been a lot of places. Of all the places you've visited in your life, what was maybe one of your favorite places?
Well, I suppose the favorite was the 14 and a quarter years I worked as parish worker at West Market Street United Methodist Church, because there I was in ministry every day and every night for those over 14 years, and that was a special blessing to me. Of course, the Holy Land, the traveling there after I retired was a great place. It's meant a lot to me through the years to look back, and as I read the scripture, feel so close to God, to Jesus in his life from that trip. And of course, I ran around with Bobby and Wayne and them and Angie and Richard and Angie and Philip, and I've loved it. But I guess one of the main things is look back where you were happy. And I was happy in the ministry. I never wanted to leave any place we lived because it was great. We were in Concord when Horace died. Prior to that, we were in Welcome. And that was a great place to live. We had a hard time getting the parsonage livable, but we did. And I had such a thrill there. I asked them to let's start a library. And we cleaned out a little closet room and made a library. And then I was always buying books for people to put in that. The library has expanded and grown through the years. Oh my goodness, how many more could I talk about?
like a river attendeth my way. When sorrows like sea billows roll, whatever my lot, you have taught me to say, it is well. It is well with my soul.
It is. One last thing. What is the secret of living to 90 years old?
I think one thing is taking life as it comes to you, one day at a time. And when you go to bed at night, turn it over to the Lord. And even though problems may come at night, then joy comes in the morning. And my mother always said that if things look bad, go ahead and sleep, and they'll look altogether different on a new day. And I suppose that's one philosophy that I've tried to go to bed at night. With peace, even during sickness and death and in problems. God said, I will never leave you nor forsake you. And He has never left me. He's never forsaken me, even though I haven't always been true and faithful as I could have been and should have been. But He was always faithful. He never failed me. And Jesus never fails. And in this life, we're going to have some tribulations, but He said, be of good cheer. I have overcome the world. And even at 90, I hope if I have another year or two, whatever the Lord gives me, that I will be able to share this witness till the last day of my life upon the earth.
Amen.
Thank you.